Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Let us pray. Loving God, we come together to celebrate your Son, whose birth restored hope to the world. In this season of joy, we pray for those that need hope today, for those in darkness or despair who need the hope of your light, those burdened by loss who need the hope of your comfort, those surrounded by conflict and war who need the hope of your peace, and those without refuge, the oppressed who need the hope of your compassionate mercy and justice. Help us, your church, to fulfill your purpose on earth. May we be your arm of hope, reaching far beyond the walls of worship into the world. We thank you for the gift of your Son, who alone can satisfy the longing of our hearts. Until that day when we see you face to face, we wait with joyful expectation in the blessed hope of Jesus' birth and Jesus' life. Amen. I would invite you to stand and join us in singing the first of our hymns this evening. The music will be in your hymnal, but the words will be traditional and on the screen. Let's stand and sing, "O Come All Ye Faithful."
This is from Genesis chapter 22, verses 15 through 18. The angel called out to Abraham, "Because you obeyed God and were willing to sacrifice your only son, the Lord repeats his promise to you. Your descendants will outnumber the stars in the sky and the grains of sand on the shore. Through you, I will bless all the nations on earth, and from your bloodline, my only son will be born."
Thank you.
light of hope, a reading from the 9th chapter of Isaiah. Hope is coming for those who walk in spiritual darkness, for you will see a great light. I will give you a child that all who face certain death may find life through him. He will become a great leader, and he will be called wise and marvelous counselor, strong ruler, eternal provider and protector, the Prince of Peace. Leading with justice and righteousness, his government will be the last, and the Messiah's reign will be forever. Let us stand to sing the first Noel.
Peace of hope, from the 11th chapter of Isaiah. From the roots of David's family tree, new growth will sprout. A branch will blossom and bear fruit. He will have the Spirit of God, judging people with compassion and justice. In that day, the wild beast will no longer stalk the weaker animal. Both hunter and prey will live peacefully side by side. Even a little child will lead them without fear, for the garden will be restored. Creation will be free from harm, and all the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord.
Author and activist Alice Walker has said that the most important question in the world is this: why is the child crying? And she said, it just seems clear to me that as long as we're all here, it's pretty clear that the struggle is to share the planet rather than to divide it. Our gifts this evening help us strengthen one another and to offer hope in the world. Let us gather our gifts together and present them as an offering to God. Well, the offering is being collected. I would invite you to join to sing together. Come, thou long expected Jesus.
Oh,
Let us pray. With these gifts, dear God, accept the praise and thanksgiving of our hearts. Transform what we have offered this evening to point to your presence throughout the world and to further your dream. We offer this and these in the name of Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. Amen.
The fulfillment of hope, a reading from the first chapter of Luke. In the city of Nazareth, a girl named Mary was engaged to Joseph, a descendant of David. One day, the angel Gabriel appeared to her. "You will have a son," he told her, "and you are to call him Jesus. This child will be the Son of God, the promised hope. The Lord will give him the throne of David, and he will rule over his kingdom forever." And though Mary did not fully understand how this would happen, she was obedient and said, "I am God's willing servant. Let your word be fulfilled through me." Then the angel left her.
What a beautiful name it is, the name of
The restoration of hope, a reading from the second chapter of Luke. When the Roman government ordered a census of the people, Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem to register. While they were there, Mary gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in cloth, and because there was no room for them in the inn, she placed the baby in a manger used for feeding hay to animals. Message of hope, continuing Luke's second chapter. That night in the fields outside of Bethlehem, a group of shepherds guarded their flock of sheep. Suddenly an angel appeared before them, and the sky was filled with brilliant light. "Do not be afraid," said the angel. "I have come to bring you good news. A child, the promised Savior, has been born in Bethlehem. You will find him wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." The hills then echoed with the sound of angels singing. Glory to God. As they had appeared, they were gone. The shepherds left immediately and found the child just as the angel had said. Let us join together to sing, standing, "Hark the Herald Angels Sing."
After Jesus was born, a group of astronomers noticed a new star in the sky. Familiar with the ancient prophecy, they knew that this event signaled the birth of the long-awaited hope of Israel, the one would be her king. So they followed the star that led them to the place where Jesus was.
Thank you.
Gospel according to John. Before the world was made, Christ existed. He was with God and was himself God. Out of darkness, shining as the light of life, he created everything that lives. After the fall, the world was filled with darkness again. So the life-giving light came to the world in human form. Although Jesus was born into the same world that God made, many people saw Jesus as a stranger. Those who recognize Jesus then and now receive the light that and become God's children. And this is our living hope. The light of life shines in the darkness. The true light is the only one, the one and only light. And all who see it will have seen the light of God. No, not one thing, not even darkness, can extinguish this light. Throughout this season of Advent, we have prepared ourselves by lighting lights of hope and peace and joy and love, and tonight we bring the light of Christ into the world. This is a mighty light, a light brought forth from all the preparations we have made, a light that you can know is so strong that not all the darkness in the world has the power to extinguish the light of even one tiny flickering flame. Tonight, as we sing, the light is shared, the light is brought to you, so you may let your light shine, and you may let it shine before all people that others too will know the light and give glory to God in heaven and on earth. We stand and sing together, O Holy Night, as we share the light of Christ to all.
Thank you.
Go now as messengers of God's hope. Where there is darkness, shine the hope of light. Where there is conflict, shine the light of peace. Where there is despair, share the hope of the gift of eternal life. May you live in service to God, whose promise is fulfilled, whose hope is restored, and who is alive in you through the birth of his Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Joy to